Now, let's proceed looking at Power Automate. And as we've seen in the previous skills, each and every power tool that we've used seem to have a trend where we have different types of platforms where we achieve different types of tasks. For example, when you're looking at Power BI, we noticed that we could make use of the Power BI desktop as an area to configure different types of analysis or project different types of financials, etc. And we also had access to the Power BI service, which allows us to visualize the different types of dashboards that we have within our environment. Now, the same does apply when it comes to Power Automate. We also have over here the Power Automate desktop. So let's say here Power Auto desktop. And we also have the Power Automate portal. Now, these serve different types of purposes. For example, the Power Automate desktop is ideal for creating desktop-based automations. Now, if you simply want to automate something that is local to your machine, like interacting with your desktop files or maybe applications, or even things such as your PowerShell and your command prompt, you can actually rely on Power Automate desktop to accomplish such. The Power Automate portal, on the other hand, is a cloud-based service for building flows that allow you to connect and integrate different types of flows to your cloud applications and services. It's more suited for automating cloud-based tasks such as managing your email, if you simply want to automate that, or maybe your databases. You could have some SQL databases in the cloud that you simply want to be able to manage, and various types of online services. Now, if we launch Power Automate Desktop, you'd notice that there are quite a lot of features and tools we can leverage within this particular area. And from Power Automate Desktop, you also have areas that allow you to leverage Copilot or even set up different types of questions to discover what exactly you'd like to automate. Now, if we scroll down here, you have some insights and templates that you can use to get started. However, the concept of you having this is to be able to create flows. So we can create flows from right over here where it says new flow, or we can go to my flows to discover any other flows that are currently existing within our environment. And here, anything that we actually configure would be tied into that particular system where this Power Automate desktop is installed. So if you go and select new flow, for example, you would notice that over here you have access to the different types of areas where you can configure a new flow. So over here, you simply have to go ahead and give it a name. So let's say we simply want to be able to monitor the various resources within the environment. You can say this is going to be a resource monitor. And then we have Power FX enabled. Now, this is currently in preview, but Microsoft allows us to make use of it up until it is really released out there. Now, FX allows us to make use of different code. We can actually make use of different formulas and use Excel-like kind of formulas to deliver different types of flows we'd like to have within our environment. So we can choose to preview that, or we can simply disable that. It's up to us depending on what exactly we want to achieve. So let's go ahead and click on create so that we can be able to look at what exactly we can achieve over here. Oh, two of them actually opened. Let's quickly close that. So this is the beginning section of our flow. And you can see over here, we can actually go ahead and play. If we have already configured that, we can stop it. We can have a preview. We can also, after editing, delete this particular flow. So it's currently in editing, and this allows us to go ahead and even begin working on it. But before we can actually jump into that, let's continue discovering the portal. So over here we have shared with me. If you have any flows that have been shared with you, you'd also be able to see them in here. You also have examples of different types of flows, like I showed you earlier, that you have access to different insights over here, such as tutorials. You have different types of useful links that you can use to get started. So this is very similar to what you'd see under examples, allowing you to automate different types of tasks, whether they're Excel automations, web automations, we have desktop automations. So this is very helpful, and you can actually get started based on these templates provided in this particular area. Now, there are times when there are certain types of flows that are at a premium level. You might want to access them, but based on the license that you have, you might not be able to have access to those. So if you wanted to go premium, you have an option over here that allows you to do so. And that brings us over here where we can go ahead and make use of RPA. Now, RPA, also known as robotic process automation, is a cool feature that allows you to make use of bots or software robots that actually mimic human actions, just clicking or typing or extracting data from different data sources, or even just interacting with various applications. If you do a lot of maybe data processing, such as data entry, maybe generating different types of reports, you can leverage RPA to accomplish those tasks. Currently, you can run a trial version. I'm not sure whether by the completion of this course, this would still be on trial, but you can have a 90-day access to this platform to perform different types of tasks using RPA. Other than that, you also have access to your environment. So it's very important that when you're performing different types of flows, you make sure that they are tied to a particular environment. Now, it is very important for us to actually work with that because each and every flow that we create is environment specific. So if we're creating flows for, let's say, the CRM or the test environment, we have to make sure that we are in that environment when creating those types of flows. The settings area is also very important, allowing us to make various types of changes to this particular Automate desktop area. You have auto start application. If you'd like to have that, so that applications can be automatically restarted. You have the option to keep the application running once it has been closed, and many other options that are provided over here, such as running updates. Now, updates are very important. You'd notice sometimes when you launch Power Automate Desktop, it will require you to update, and if you do not update, you lose out on the latest features that are provided in there. So it is always wise to once in a while come to this area and ensure that you are up to date, and also enable this option so that you're notified each and every time there's an update that Microsoft has released. Data collection simply allows us to permit Microsoft to collect data from this particular software so as to allow them to continually improve the product. And there is our Copilot, very important for automating and using AI in Power Automate. And if we head back to my flows, where we actually can access our resource monitor flow, you'd notice that we have various resources that we can implement from here. So here is our resource monitor flow. So once we have it created, it will pop up in this window like so. And from this window, notice that we have various options over here, variables, conditionals, we have loops, we have flow control, we have run flows. Now, these are different types of flows we can actually create within our environment. We have system, and over here, you can see different types of flows we can actually set up. We have workstation. We also have, like I said, the command prompt. It should be somewhere over here. So we have CMD sessions that we can actually automate over here. There is just a lot that we can do with this environment. And some of these, like you're seeing over here, these are premium services such as login, SharePoint, Microsoft Forms, etc. But once you have a premium license, you then can have the access to make use of these features in this particular area. Now, the Power Automate Desktop is actually packed with all these tools. How about the Power Automate Portal itself? Well, if you want to access the Power Automate Portal, you simply have to type mac.powerautomate.com, or you can simply sign into your portal in Microsoft 365, and if you have the license to Power Tools, you'll see that from here you have access to various resources such as your Power BI, your Power Automate, etc., and you can actually choose it from that particular area over there. All right, now from here you can actually see that within Power Automate we have various options. The create allows us to begin the process of creating flows within Power Automate portal, and we also have different types of options over here that we can make use of, as you can see. But the basic idea or the fundamental concept is that we're simply interacting with cloud-based services and enabling us to be able to automate different types of tasks by creating flows within those environments. You have templates as well that you can make use of to create different types of flows based on those templates and topics. You also have My Flows over here, which would list the different flows that you have in the environment. And if you want to learn or simply have tutorials that will give you insight into what you have to do, there is that Microsoft Learn, which allows you to have insights into the various components of this particular product. And below that, we have approvals, which are really great. Now, approvals would be very helpful when we simply want to be able to action certain activities. For example, when a particular item is created, we want somebody to approve it, and then we can set up various conditions that actually help us to identify whether that particular item must be approved or not. So there is a lot that we're going to cover as we progress. And even after that, there is a lot more that you're going to discover as you continue working with Power Automate.
Thanks for watching, and remember to hit that subscribe button to get the latest from CBT Nuggets. And if you're new to IT or just keen to sharpen your IT skills, then be sure to check out cbtnuggets.com and sign up for a free trial.